We're going to continue our talk about 7.6, which is again dealing with proportions and solving rational equations when we have a word problem. The last problems we're going to do and the problems we're doing today on this video are going to be distance rate time problems. So first thing I want you to realize is it's not a new concept. We've always already talked and you've been tested on distance equals rate times time. The key is that you need to understand that that formula can be solved for either t or r, and if we solve for t or r, we have to divide by the other variable. So I do want to stress that I set my problems up slightly different than she does in the book. When y'all watch her videos, you can do it either way, but I always put mine rate times time equals distance. I don't rearrange because I think if you rearrange, it's easier to get confused. And why I do it this way is that I know if I'm going left to right, I'm multiplying, and if I'm going right to left, I have to divide. It's just a way to kind of keep clear, am I multiplying or am I dividing? So I always set mine up this way. You can do it either way, as long as you're labeling it. Also, other side note is we don't have to see a chart, but a chart is super valuable, highly recommended, but we have to see an equation and the equation has to be valid. And then you have to show us the steps of solving it. So again, I want you to read the problem, pause it right now, read the problem, try to set it up, and then start it again when you think you have the video, you have the equation. So when I read this, it says a car travels 180 miles. So look for the units. That means 180 is my distance, and the same time the truck travels 120 miles. So we have 120 for this spot. And if the car speed is 20 miles per hour faster than the truck speed, find the cars in the truck speed. What I want to stress is sometimes it's easier to set the problem up to where it's not what it's directly solving for. If you can set it up to where it's what it's solving for, that's great. That actually helps you save a step. But I do find some of these problems it's easier to set it up and then go back. And that's why I like a chart. You know exactly what you set your variable up to. So in this case, cars is going 20 miles per hour faster, which means we add it to it. So the car would be X plus 20, where the rate would be for the truck would be X. And we will always get enough information to fill two of the columns directly. So now we're going to use the idea that, again on this one, that T equals distance divided by rate. That's what we're using to fill in that column here. So I have 120 divided by x, and I have 180 divided by x plus 20. We now need to look back at the word problem and say, what did they give us that tells us a relationship between the time? And there's your key word. It says same time. So that means we set these two times equal to each other for our equation. So 120x over x equals 180 over x plus 20. We now have a proportion, which again is easier to solve because we're going to cross multiply. Now I do want to say you should realize that x cannot be 0 and x cannot be a negative 20, which would be restrictions, but that's obvious because we aren't going to deal with a truck going 0 miles per hour. So I'm cross multiplying now. I get 120 times x plus 20 equals 180x. I'm going to multiply out and distribute, so I get 120x plus 2400, and you can use your calculator for any of the ones you're not quite sure on. We're now going to subtract 120 from both sides, 120x, and we will get 2400 equals 60x. Divide both sides by 60. At least you should see the zeros cancel. 240 divided by 6 will give me a 40. What I like about doing a chart is I am super clear what I just solved for. X is actually the rate of the truck. Look back at the problem. They wanted the cars and this truck speed. So my answer for this problem, the truck is what we just solved for, is 40 miles per hour. And the car, we add 20 because it's X plus 20, gives us 60 miles per hour. One caution to say is when you're typing it into my math lab, make sure you type it into the correct answer block. People think, oh, well, I had the right answer, but I put it in the wrong answer block. But that's really important. The truck speed is different than the car speed. So double check what you're solving for. That's why I really, really emphasize using a chart. So we're now going to go to number 6. Please pause it and read the problem. Try to set it up. Remember, we're still going to set it up again in the same format, which is slightly different than she'll do on her charts when you watch her videos in my math lab. Tells me a jogger begins her workout by jogging to the park 12 miles. So to the park is 12 miles. She jogs home at the same speed but on a different route. So the return trip takes 18 miles. Her time is 1 hour longer. Now, there are two things that I could use here, and this is where I'm telling you that they're going to use it slightly different than what I may use. I actually see this. I see same speed and time is 1 hour. So I actually use the time is 1 hour because I think that's easier to put in the chart and to use the word same as my last step. But if you do it the other way, it will work as well. So I'm going to call the time there X, and the time back is X plus 1 because that's the 1 hour longer. We now, again, are using distance equals rate times time, which means the rate equals distance divided by time. So we're going to now take the 12 divided by x, take the 18 divided by x plus 1. This is what I'm going to use because it said same speed. So I'm going to use the proportion, which is so much easier to solve. So 12 over x equals 18 over x plus 1. I'm going to cross multiply. It gives me 12 times parentheses x plus 1 equals 18x. Get rid of my parentheses by distributing the 12. Get 12x plus 12 equals 18x. And I'm going to subtract 12x from both sides. When I subtract 12x from both sides, I get 12 equals 6x. X equals 12 over 6, which is 2. This is the caution, though. If you do it the way I did it, we have to be super clear on what we just solved for. We just solved for the time. So 2 is the time to the park. So it's 2 hours. Is that what I wanted? When I look at this problem, what I want from this is I want her jogging speed. Her jogging speed is the 12 over x or the 18 over x plus 1 because the same speed. So it's going to be easier to use the 12 over x, which is the rate. So 12 divided by 2 equals 6. And so her jogging speed is 6 miles per hour. Now, I just want to show you, just so you understand, it wouldn't have mattered if we did 18 over x plus 1, which would be 18 over 3, which still is 6 miles per hour. Common mistake here is to tell me that the answer is 2, and she's going to set this problem up differently. I think it's easier to set it up this way. It just takes one extra step at the end, but as long as you've made the chart, it's super easy to see what you have. Going to number 7. Make sure you pause it, read it, try to set it up again. Key on this problem is we're talking about a tailwind, and we're talking about against the wind, which can also be called a headwind. So this is also the same idea as a current, and you need to stop and think about what happens. If a plane is going a certain miles per hour, the tailwind is going to help it. The headwind is going to go against it, so it's going to hurt it. So that's going to deal with how we're going to set this problem up. Plane flies 630 miles with it, so with the wind is 630, flies only 455 miles. And the key here, again, is there's the same amount of time. So that's going to be an important one. And we want to try to use that last if we can. So the other part we want to know is we actually want to know what's the rate of the plane in still air. So we start with X. And with a tailwind with the wind, which is helping them, we add 35. And against the wind, it's going to hurt it. So we subtract 35. My T equals distance divided by rate. So I have 630. Divided by x plus 35 for the time with the wind, and I have 455 over x minus 35 against the wind. I'm going to now use that idea of the same amount of time, so I'm going to set up the proportion. 630 over x plus 35 equals 455 over x minus 35. Cross multiply. That's why this section is, the proportions are so important. So we have 630 times x minus 35 equals 455 times x plus 35. Please use your calculator to multiply this piece out. I don't expect you to be able to do this in your head, and nor do I really want you to do it in your head. It's too easy to make careless mistakes that way. So I have 630x, and if I type that in my calculator, I'm going to get 22,050 equals 455x plus, and if I do that one in my calculator, I get 15,925. I'm now going to collect like terms on the same side, subtracting the 455x from both sides so that those cancel. And when I subtract those two, I am going to get 175x. I'm going to add the 22,050 to both sides so that those cancel. And when I add those two together, I will get 37,975. My last step, using again my calculator, take 37,975 and I divide it by 175 in my calculator. Again, I let it do that for me and I get 217. Right off the bat, let's look back. What were we using? What were we asked for? X actually in this problem is what we want to find, which is the rate of the plane in still air. So my answer is 217 miles per hour. So number 8 and number 9 are actually review problems, meaning that you actually should have been able to do these on the first test when we had our distance rate time problems. So I really want you to pause this, read and do 8 and 9 before you watch the videos. I want to see if you remember how to set it up. But notice I've already set up my chart. Same way, always, rate times time equals distance. Don't change the order around. Set it up, solve it, make sure what you solve for is what they're asking for. So we have two trains traveling in opposite directions. One train is traveling 10 miles per hour faster than the other. So I'll call one of their rates x, and one will be x plus 10 because it's faster. Key here is in 4.5 hours. They both left at the same time, and then they went 4.5. So their times actually match. I'm going to multiply across because that's my column that I have left. And the trains are going, again, remember, in opposite directions. So this is a total distance problem, which means I'm going to add them together. So I have 4.5x plus 4.5 times the x plus 10 equals 414. That's my equation. That's what we mandatory need to see on your paper. So I'm going to get rid of my parentheses by using distributive property. I'm going to collect like terms. So add my 4.5s together. That gives me a 9x. And I'm going to also subtract 45 from both sides, which gives me a 369. So all I did here from step 2 to 3, collect like terms on the same side, and I subtracted 45 from both sides. And again, you can use your calculator to do that piece. So my last step here is to take 369 and divide it by 9 in my calculator, and I get 41. Look back at what X is in my chart, which is super helpful. X is my rate for my train one, and it actually says find the speed for each one. So my train one was 41 miles per hour, and my train two would be x plus 10, which would give me 51 miles per hour. Not a new concept, easy for you to follow. Looking at our last one, number 9, we have two hikers 14 miles apart, and they're walking towards each other. So I do want you to realize this is still a total distance problem. We have the total distance in the beginning, and we're saying how long does it take for them to reach each other. So they meet in 2 hours. So that's the same amount of time for both of them. And find the rate of each hiker if one of them walks 1.8 miles per hour faster than the other. So we have x and x plus 1.8. This is essentially the same setup as above on number 8. So we multiply across, I get 2x, and I get 2 times x plus 1.8. The total distance is 14, so we add them together. Again, this is a concept from that first test, so this is also a good review. You will have a distance rate time problem on this test and on the final. So I'm going to get rid of my parentheses. Get 2x plus 2x plus, and again, you can use your calculator, that's 3.6. Add my like terms together, subtract the 3.6 from both sides. When I subtract that, I get 10.4. Divide 10.4 by 4, and I get 2.6. What is this? It is my rate, which is what I wanted. So the hiker's, the first hiker's rate is 2.6 miles per hour, which is a legitimate number. We add 1.8 to the second number, which gives us 4.4 miles per hour for the second person. You will have a distance rate time problem on the test. You will have a work problem on your test. Make sure you're confident with both forms.